Greetings of the day, dear students. Welcome back to your English literature class. Today, we are going to read lesson 4 from Beehive, titled A Truly Beautiful Mind. Great men are not born with special science. In their childhood days, they are also like common children, and their likes and dislikes are very much similar to them. Their parents also take care of them as normally parents do. Gradually, these children develop some specific virtues and become great when they grow up. That is the story of a truly beautiful mind that we are going to read about in today's lesson. The story is of Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein was born on March 14, 1879 in the German city of Ulm. He had no signs of greatness, and even his mother thought that he was somewhat of a freak. His head was bigger than the other children, and till the age of 2.5 years, he did not speak anything. And when he learned to speak, he spoke everything twice. He was boring for other children, so he played by himself much of the time. He loved mechanical toys. Looking at his newborn sister Marja, he had asked, "She is okay, but where are her wheels?" A headmaster once told Einstein's father that they should not worry about Einstein, because whatever profession he would choose, he would never be successful in that. Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6, just because his mother wanted him to. He later became a gifted amateur violinist and maintained this skill throughout his life. Einstein was good at studies. He joined a high school in Munich. He scored good marks in every subject, but he always clashed with teachers. He did not like the strict discipline and order in schools. He left school for good at the age of 15. A year before his parents moved to Milan, they left him with relatives. He was able to continue his education in Switzerland. He decided to study at the University of Zurich after schooling. He was highly gifted in mathematics and he loved physics. Einstein had a special interest in a fellow student named Mileva Marek. She was a clever creature and a Serb. The University of Zurich was one of the few universities in Europe where women could get degrees. Therefore, she had come to Switzerland. The couple fell in love. However, their love was expressed in signs. There are letters shared between Einstein and Mileva that are proof that their affection was put into words, mixing signs with tenderness. At the age of 21, Einstein worked as a technical assistant and finally secured the job of a technical expert in the patent office in Bern in 1902. He also worked secretly on developing his own ideas. He called his desk as the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. While he was solving problems in physics, his private life was unraveling. He wanted to marry Mileva, but his mother was completely against him marrying Mileva, as she was bothered by Mileva's intelligence. But finally, he married her. They could not live together, and finally, the couple divorced in 1919. Later, Albert married his cousin the very same year. Einstein's new personal chapter coincided with his rise to world fame. He published his General Theory of Relativity in 1915. The newspapers proclaimed his work as a scientific revolution. He received the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921 and was lauded by the press all over the world. when the Nazis came to power in 1933, Einstein immigrated to the United States of America. 5 years later, the discovery of nuclear fission in Berlin had American physicists in an uproar. Many of them fled, as Einstein had, and they were afraid that the Nazis could become and use an atomic bomb. At the urging of a colleague, Einstein wrote a letter to Franklin D. Roosevelt, the American president, and warned him that a single nuclear bomb would make a mass destruction. His words did not fail to have an effect, but the effect was not what Einstein had thought. The Americans secretly developed an atomic bomb and dropped them on the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in August 1945. Einstein was deeply shaken by the destruction caused by the atomic bombs. Einstein was deeply shaken by the extent of destruction. This time, he wrote a public letter to the United Nations. In it, he proposed the formation of a world government. But this letter did not prove effective. Einstein, in the next decade, involved himself in politics. He wanted to bring an end to the arms buildup. He worked for peace and democracy. Einstein died in 1955 at the age of 76. He was celebrated as a visionary and a world citizen. Albert Einstein was not just a scientific genius, but he worked as a campaigner of world peace and democracy. Albert Einstein's contribution towards science is immense, but even greater is his ideology and his dedication towards peace and democracy. So, that'll be all for today's class. Until we meet again, stay safe. Stay healthy and keep learning.